Today we are talking meal planning, and I'm going to be giving you 9 tips to make meal planning successful, or 9 tips for beginners, or if you've been meal planning for a while, this is still going to be packed with information, and hopefully you'll learn a tip or two. If you have been meal planning for a while, comment down below, what is your biggest meal planning tip? I would love to hear from you guys. Go check out the comments section. Go check out all the information, because you guys always leave such great comments. I love learning from you guys, so go check out the comments, learn from each other, talk to each other, build a community down below in the comments. Okay, so meal planning. I am so excited for this video. I have been waiting to do this for a long time now, and it's going to be packed with information. I have so many tips for you guys on meal planning and just making meal planning successful, how to not fail at it, how to not get overwhelmed with meal planning, because it can be overwhelming in the beginning and so much information, but I'm going to simplify it for you guys and help make you successful. That is what I am all about. So before we get into the tips on meal planning, first let's talk about what meal planning is. So meal planning, the way that I like to define it, is having the age-old question, what's for dinner? And usually causes a fight or a little tiff. Having that conversation once and figuring it out once for the week or once for the month versus having that talk every single night. I know that my husband and I'll ask him what he wants for dinner. I don't know. Or I'll be like, hey, do you want this for dinner? Yeah, that's fine. I'm sorry, what? That's fine? That's like the worst thing you would tell me is that's fine. I wanna, yeah, babe, that sounds amazing. Or no, thank you, not tonight. Those are the two. I don't want some lukewarm, that's fine. That just means that you don't wanna eat it, but you're not gonna tell me what you really wanna eat. That's what that is. Okay, so now that we know what meal planning is, one time that we're figuring out what we're having for dinners, what we're having for lunches, what we're having for the month, the week, whatever it is, having that conversation once, figuring it out once, and then it's done. So therefore, it's going to save you time. It's going to save you money. And I'm going to get into all of that, of how it saves time and money, in this video. The first tip is going to be shop your pantry and assess what you already have on hand. So I want you to go through your pantry, go through your freezer, go through your fridge, see what you have, see what meals you can make out of those, and also see if anything's expiring. If you have some chicken that you cooked 2 nights ago and you're like, yeah, we need to eat that up this week. Okay, we have some leftover rice. We have some leftover veggies. We gotta make these go away before they expire, because we do not want food waste. Food waste, very little things get under my skin more than food waste does. So assess what you already have. Figure out what you already have and make some meals out of them. They could be super easy meals. Say you have some leftover chicken, then you can be like, okay, let's throw a veggie in there. Let's throw a rice side or a starch side or something like that, something simple, and there's the meal. You got chicken, starch, and veggie. That sounds delicious to me. So make something simple. Figure out what you already have. Figure out what you need to extra add onto it. So if you do need to go to the store to get extra veggies, then you can go and add that to the list and add that, but you can still make the bulk of it around what you have on hand. If you guys struggle with meal planning, anything like that, what to come up with for food, I am coming out with today a 7-day meal plan for you guys. So it's a 7-day meal plan of lunches, of dinners, of whatever you want it to be. It has the 7 days for you planned out. It has recipe cards for all of the different ingredients, all the different recipes, everything you need to know, and it has a shopping list of everything. So if you want to get the meal plan, the shopping list is all inclusive. It's all categorized. It tells you you need like 3 cans of this, 2 cans of this, and 6 pounds of chicken breast or whatever it may be, but it's all together. And then it also has printables for you guys. So it is like an all-in-one 15-page printable for you guys. I'll have it linked down below in the description box and also the pinned comment, but it's free for you guys. So go check it out. I'd love for you to check out this free meal plan that I work so hard on for you guys. And I think you're really gonna enjoy it. So if something like that is something of interest for you, or you struggle with what to come up with for meals, go check out the meal plan down below. Tip number 2 is to keep the family involved. And this, I love this. So what I do with, it's just Jamie and I, but I've had so many families that have adopted this tip that I've given on getting the family involved. So whatever number of people you have in your family, each person will get a meal that week that they get to choose, that they get to look forward to. So say their meal is lasagna, and then another person is, I don't know, big ziti, and I'm choosing that pasta, and then another person is, I don't know, shrimp something. breaded shrimp. I don't eat seafood, but breaded shrimp. So each person has a night that they get to choose, and then it's something that they look forward to. So rather than looking at the meal planning and being like, I don't like those, I don't want that, I don't like this stuff, that doesn't sound good, you can be like, okay, but little Susie, on Thursday it's your dinner, so we're gonna eat tonight's dinner because it's the one your sister picked out. But on Thursday, it's your dinner. And so it gives them something to look forward to and it gets them involved. I also have a recipe binder, and this is something that I've put together. It has recipes that I printed out online. It has family recipes. It has recipe cards, little note cards that I took from my grandma, and all of these different recipes that are in there. And I put it in this binder. And so when I'm stumped, when the family's stumped, I can give it to them and be like, okay, you pick a recipe, you pick something. And then it kind of gives you ideas, and I'll flip through and I'll be like, okay, I got nothing, or I need three more meals this week. What else can I do? I'll flip through the binder and be like, oh yeah, that sounds really good. Or, oh yeah, I can make that. And then I even put notes in this. This would go well with peas, or this would go well with this, or add this to it, or this was really good. Jamie really loved this one. So that's a really great way to get the family involved, and so that it's not like, eh, I got nothing. Or when Jamie doesn't want what's on the meal plan, I'm like, you picked that meal this week. So guess what? We're eating it and you're gonna be excited. Number three is gonna be theme nights. And theme nights are really fun. It's a great way to just enjoy dinner and have something to look forward to and have tradition of, you know, Meatless Monday, Taco Tuesday, Grilling Wednesday, Pasta Thursday, whatever it may be, and having those theme weeks every single week. So that is something that you look forward to, and it's something that is just easy, and you already have that dinner figured out. You know, every single Tuesday you're having tacos or some form of Mexican food, and then you don't have to worry about it. You don't have to come up with a new recipe each week because you got tacos. You got it. You may want to mix up the toppings in it, but you already have the base of what you're having every single week for those days. Number four is to use leftover food for the next day's meal. So this is something that you can do, like extra rice for tomorrow's lunches, or extra rice for tomorrow's casserole, or whatever it may be, or cooking a little bit extra. Sometimes I'll cook extra rice so that I know that I can have chicken and rice tonight, but then tomorrow I can cook that into a casserole. And so it's two totally different flavors and two totally different dinners, but the same main ingredient. Or the same thing with chicken. Sometimes I'll cook extra chicken or have Jamie grill extra chicken so that we can use it for multiple meals. And that's going to save time. It's going to save money. You don't have to cook the rice again or the chicken again or whatever it is again. You're only cooking that part once. And so it's going to save you a lot of time, a lot of money, and you may even be able to use it as a full meal, or cooking the whole meal, but cooking a little bit, couple extra servings extra for lunches the next day. And then you get meal prep lunches, and then you're not going out and going to the drive-thru. You're not getting takeout for lunches for work, so it's gonna save money all around. Number five is to use the same ingredient in multiple different meals. Now this is very similar to the previous tip, but it's very specific. When I'm writing my meal plan, I'm looking at the ingredient list and being like, okay, how can I use this in multiple different meals? What ingredients can I use in multiple different ways? I really, really focused on this in the 7-day meal plan that I wrote for you guys. I made sure that a lot of the ingredients were ones that you used in multiple recipes, so you weren't having leftover food, so you weren't having like leftover tortillas or something like that and being like, what the heck am I gonna do with this? These go stale. No, they're gonna be used in multiple different meals and different flavors. So for instance, for tortillas, you may have tortillas in like enchiladas, but then in a totally separate flavor, you can have chicken Caesar wraps. So it's gonna be two totally different meals, different flavors, but it's still gonna use up all their tortillas. They're not gonna go to waste. They're not just gonna sit in your cupboard because no one has anything to do with those last tortillas. They're like, well, I guess they're just gonna go bad. And then when we clean out the pantry, they get thrown out. So base your meal plan on the same ingredients for multiple different meals. Number six is to have a loose, structured meal plan. So yes, it's great to plan out your days, plan out your schedule. And when I'm writing my meal plan, I'll typically look at like what meetings we have, what different things. Like every Monday night I have a mastermind call, so I know that I have to have a simple dinner on that night. But then on Wednesdays, it's a little bit more loose. I can have more time to cook a full dinner. So I'll plan that into my meal plan. But with that being said, I have a loose structured meal plan. So yes, I have the days figured out of Monday I'm gonna have this, Tuesday I'm gonna have this, whatever day it is. But if something comes up, I can move them around. I can switch up the meals, and I'm not like rigid, set in stone, whatever it is. Because sometimes life happens. Sometimes you got a meeting. Sometimes a kid is sick. Sometimes whatever it may be, or like a meeting runs late. But whatever it is, you just have to be flexible and be like, okay, we can move Taco Tuesday to Taco Thursday, and it's totally fine. So be flexible in your meal plan. Number 7, this one is a doozy. I don't know why I say doozy. You guys comment on me saying doozy, but it's a doozy. So only shop once a week. I know I get so many comments of that. This is a really big struggle for you guys of only shopping once a week. You guys go to the grocery store for pretty much every meal, and it's hard. And it's hard to learn that, breaking that habit of going to the grocery store whenever you cook dinner or whatever it is, but really get in the habit of only shopping once a week. So this is gonna do a bunch of things. It is going to cut down on impulse purchases. That's the biggest one, because every time you go to the store, most likely you're throwing other things in the cart. It's gonna save time, because let's be honest, it takes a lot of time to go to the grocery store, and each time that you're going, it's gonna be an extra 10, 15 minutes each way, all of that. It's gonna also save on the urge to eat out. So I know that we struggle with this, and I'm sure you guys struggle with this as well. If you're opening the fridge and there's nothing in there, that's the last thing you wanna do, is then go to the store and cook whatever it is. You just wanna get takeout. You just wanna get delivery. So when you have that empty fridge, when you're only shopping per meal, then you're like, eh, let's just get takeout. Let's just order pizza, whatever it is. But if you have a full fridge stocked of food, then you're like, okay, like we got food in here, we can do this. And so it really makes it easier for you to break that habit. So only shop once a week, and maybe even move up to shopping every other week or shopping once a month. I have really gotten in the habit, if I don't need to go to the grocery store, I don't. Quarantine, I don't know what quarantine did to me, but this, like every single Sunday, typically after church on Sundays, I would go to the grocery store every single week, because that's what you do, right? Well, now that quarantine happened, I was like, I don't want to go out there. I don't want to be exposed, all that stuff. It's coming back down here in South Florida. So I went one time 3 weeks without going to the grocery store, because I was like, we have so much food in this house, we can definitely go. We have tons of stuff in the freezer, we have pantry full, all this stuff. We lasted 3 weeks before I had to go to the store. Even last week, I was like, there's nothing that I like desperately need, that desperately I can't live without. Yeah, there's stuff that I would want to buy, but if I want to buy those couple items, that $20 is going to turn into like $70 real quick. So I'm just going to stop and not go. And it's really going to help me not to have those impulse purchases and really just be disciplined. So unless you need to go, try and stretch it out. Try and see, you know, how you can go. If you are going to the grocery store every day, every meal, try going 3 days and like make it a little bit easier so that you don't have to go every day. If you do want to dig deeper on how to meal plan, how to save money on groceries, how to meal prep, all of that, I have full modules on those topics in my course, How to Save Money on Groceries. I go deep into meal planning, deep into meal prepping, deep into rolling over ingredients, deep into so many different topics. There's over 20 videos on it, self-paced course. So if you do want to dig deeper into those topics, I have a link down below in the description box on the course. It's super affordable, and I really think that that is gonna help you to really move on to the next level in saving money. Number 8 is to plan meals around what's on sale. So after you go through and shop your pantry, figure out what meals you're making out of those, go through the flyers, go through the apps. I know Aldi has an app, Kroger has an app, all these companies, all these grocery stores have apps. Go through the apps, go through or pull up their website online, see what's on sale, and then build your meal plan around those sales as well. So you can go and get, you know, oh, ribs is on sale, or chicken breast is on sale, or whatever it is, and be like, okay, that'd be really good. We'll do this, we'll do that. And that's really gonna help save some crazy money. Tip number 9 is to have a backup plan. So yes, we have a meal plan. Yes, we have the full week all planned out. We're excited for it. But let's be honest, guys, life happens and stuff happens. And sometimes you forgot to thaw the chicken, or sometimes, you know, a meeting runs late, whatever it is. Have a backup plan at all times. You should have two or three different recipes that you can pull out of your pantry, out of your freezer at any time. So whether they be those freezer meals, the like Ziploc freezer meals that you do and you just dump in a crock pot or Instant Pot, whether you have frozen chicken breast and then you just tie it with a rice and a frozen veggie, that is a meal that you can have on stock at all times, and then you just throw it in the oven or whatever it may be and you're good to go. So have those backup meals for when life happens, when something happens, and you can just throw them in, whether it be, you know, you have kids and maybe you have something where you just need a really quick meal for them, you know, chicken tenders, whatever it is that you can just throw in the oven. It doesn't have to be the healthiest. It's okay, guys, but just have something on hand at all times so that you're not having to run through the drive-thru, because that's really gonna add up the cost. So like I said, I do have this free 7-day meal plan. If you guys want to get it, down below in the description box, I'd be so excited if you guys do it. If you do get it, I would love for you to take a picture, tag me on Instagram at freedomandabudget. I would love that. I love seeing you guys using my products and using my spreadsheets and using all of that stuff. It just makes my day. Love it, love it, love it. If you want to know 5 easy money hacks to improve your finances, click this video here. And if you want to know about my favorite app, Fetch Rewards, how I get free groceries, check out this video here. Hey, no, no, no.